So I designed this sheet for a networking group that I belong to. And in this networking group, we meet every second week. And the fees for the networking group is $25 every second week. They need to calculate how far along these people have paid. And so what I have done here, first of all, is let me show you how it works. So let's say that Dan Honey here decided to pay $100. Okay, so right now we have just three cells colored in. And so we'll put the $100 in here and we'll calculate. And now Dan Honey has four additional cells added to the total. So how I formatted the sheet was I made a grid because there's only 20 people in our club. I have changed the widths of these columns to 3. I have formatted the dates by clicking on Format Cells, and then I chose the alignment going this way. Now, what you can't see here is that every cell that is paid has a P being displayed here. I formatted the cells so that if they have a P in them, then you turn them green. And so every cell that contains a value P will change to green. Now, how I eliminated the P being visible is I have changed both the format, the fill color to green, and the font color to green so that you can no longer see the values. So the other thing that I have done here is I have hidden columns. And so basically you don't need to see these, but what this is, it is the grand total that's right here divided by 25, and that gives you the 8, and that's the number of cells that are shaded in green. The formula I have for each of the cells is if T2, which is this one here, and I have only absolutely referenced the column and not the row, that if it's greater than or equal to 9, then I put a P in there, and if not, it's blank. And so the formula is basically just the S2 divided by 25, and that's the number of meetings that they have paid for. Now, on this calculate button, I have written a little bit of code. And so what I've done is I have started with the row number as 2 because we have headings in the first row. And so I'm saying do while cells X1, which is the name, is not blank, then if cells X18, which is the amount that they paid, if it's equals to 0, then you go to end E, which is just before the loop. Else, if sheet 1 sells X19, which is the running total, equals sheets 1 sells X18, which is the value that's entered, plus the value that's existing in X19. And then the second line is simply sheets 1 sells X18 value equals 0 to zero it out. And then it goes down the loop again. So that's how you create a payment grid in Excel. Please subscribe.